गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम मिस्टर अभिजीत पाटिल, लेक्चरर इन मैथमेटिक्स फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक मुंबई. सो आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द कोर्स बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स विच इज़ हैविंग द कोड SC19109. द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज डिटर्मिनेंट्स. नाउ दीज आर द लर्निंग आउटकम्स. First one is you will able to explain the definition of determinant. You will able to find the value of the determinant. So let us recall something which already we have learned in the school days. The representation ABCD is defined as determinant of order 2. Numbers ABCD are called elements of the determinant. In this arrangement, there are two rows and two columns. You can see that the first row is AB, second row is CD, first column is AC, second column is BD. The value of the determinant is AD minus BC, which is obtained by doing the cross multiplication AD minus BC. Now, these are some simple examples. First one is evaluate the determinant 79 minus 43, which is equal to, using the formula AD minus BC, you can multiply these two elements minus multiplication of these two elements. So I have written here 7 into 3 minus minus 4 into 9, which will be 57. So 57 is the value of the determinant. Now the second example, cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta, it is equal to cos theta into cos theta, that is cos square theta, minus minus sin theta into sin theta, that will be minus sin square theta. So it is equal to cos square theta plus sin square theta, which will be 1. So 1 is the value of the determinant. Now let us learn some new concept, that is determinant of order 3. So this is the definition. A determinant of order 3 is a square arrangement of 9 elements enclosed between two vertical bars. You can see these are two vertical bars. The elements are arranged in 3 rows and 3 columns. You can see that I have used R1, R2, R3 to denote the rows and C1, C2, C3 to denote the columns. So A21, A22, A23, this is the second row. A11, A12, A13, this is the first row. A31, A32, A33, that is the third row. So here the suffix A32. 32 stands for the third row and second column. So that suffix indicates the position of the element. The position of the element in this particular arrangement. Okay. Similarly, A21. So 21 stands for the second row and first column. So that indicates the position where the element occurs. So in general, Aij represents the element in the ith row and jth column of the determinant. Now let us see the expansion of the determinant. The determinant can be expanded as follows. D is equal to, now please listen here carefully, see these elements A11, A12 and A13. These are the elements are nothing but from the first row of the determinant A11, A12, A13, and every element is associated with some 2 by 2 determinant. Okay, and one more thing, along with A12 I have taken minus sign. Okay, so we are going to evaluate the determinant along the first row. So we will use all the three elements from the first row, and the middle element, that is A12, we will consider with the negative sign. Now how to obtain these 2 by 2 determinants, that we will see. So for A11, we will omit the first column and first row, and we will get the determinant of the remaining elements, that is A22, A23, A32, A33. Now for A12, we will omit the second column and the first row. We will get the determinant of the remaining element, that is A21, A31 and A23, A33. Okay. Now for A13, we will denote this third column and the first row and write the determinant of the remaining element, that is A21, A22, A31, A32. Okay. So this you can remember as a formula. Now see some examples. So first example, evaluate the determinant of order 3. Now as I explained you, we will evaluate along the first row. So let us consider the first element 3. Omit this column and this row. Write the determinant of the remaining elements. Then write the minus sign. Take this element -4. Omit this column and this row. Write the determinant of the remaining element, that is 1, 2, minus 2, minus 1 here. Then take this third element +5, omit this column and this row, write the determinant of the remaining elements 1, 1, 2, 3. Now you know how to simplify the 2 by 2 determinant. So using that, I have simplified this particular step. So 1 into minus 1, that is minus 1, minus 3 into minus 2. So minus of minus 6 becomes plus 6. So similarly, you can evaluate these other two determinants. And after simplification, you will get the value is 32. Now the next example, again of order 3. Sec theta, tan theta, 0, tan theta, sec theta, 0, 0, 0, 1. So it is equal to, again I will evaluate the determinant along the first row. So consider sec theta, first element, omit this column and this row and write the determinant of the remaining element, that is sec theta 001. Then write the minus sign, write this element tan theta, omit this column and this row, write the determinant of the remaining element, that is tan theta 001. Then third element is +0, omit this column and this row, write the determinant of the remaining element, that is tan theta sec theta 0 0. Now simplify this, sec theta into sec theta -0, then minus tan theta as it is, tan theta -0, then +0 into what, tan theta into 0, that is 0 -0. So no need to write that. Now sec theta into sec theta is sec square theta, minus tan theta into tan theta, that is minus tan square theta, which will be 1. Why? Because sec square theta is nothing but 1 plus tan square theta. So you can substitute here 1 plus tan square theta and minus tan square theta. So tan square theta get cancelled and you will have 1. So value of the determinant of this determinant is 1. Thank you very much. The remaining part we will learn in the next video. Happy learning.